Willie Wizard really enjoyed his flight on the magic carpet, and the very next day, after Habudan had set off back home on his own magic carpet, he called all of the animals together, and they took turns flying around the land of Where with Willie Wizard on his magic carpet. Another day, a big ship with big sails sailed into Where Harbour and docked at one of the quays there. The ship was a Spanish galleon and flew the flag of the Skull and Crossbones, being that it was a pirate ship. The King of Where sent for Willie the Wizard and asked him to go down with his son Prince Where to see what these pirates wanted. Willie Wizard and Prince Where arrived a few minutes later on the quay where the pirate ship was docked, having flown there very quickly on his new magic carpet. Willie Wizard called out to see if anybody was on board the pirate ship, but nobody replied, and there was not a sound to be heard coming from the pirate ship, inside of it or outside of it. Willie Wizard and Prince Ware decided to climb on board the pirate ship and have a look around. Nobody was on deck to greet them both, so they decided to go down below to the captain's cabin. But nobody was there either. The pirate ship was deserted, and not a soul was to be seen. Back up on the deck once again, they walked to the very front of the pirate ship, and sitting there was a very old man, dressed as a pirate of old. "Hello," Willie Wizard said quietly, but the old man didn't answer. Prince there put his hand on the shoulder of the old man, who surprised stood up, quickly reaching for his sabre. "Oh, we startled you, sorry," Prince Ware said, stepping quickly backwards. "Ah, me beauties, I didn't hear yous a-coming. I can't hear so good as I used to. You'll have to speak up a bit louder, so I can understand ye," the old man replied. Willie Wizard, in a rather loud voice, asked where all the other members of the crew were, and what they were doing here in the land of Where's Harbour. The old man told them that the crew had departed in another small boat in the night, because their pirate captain, called Captain Flag, smelt so bad, because he had never washed or brushed his teeth, had been carted off with the rest of the pirates. The old man explained that it had got to the point where he smelt so terrible that all the crew had to wear nose pegs on their noses whenever he came near to them. So the crew had decided enough was enough, and either the crew went or Captain Flag went, and after a vote, the captain lost. "Oh dear, that sounds terrible," Willie Wizard said, sitting down. The old man told them that on the way to Where, they had seen a small island, and the crew had decided to take Captain Flag there, and if he wouldn't have a bath right away and a haircut, then they would leave him there alone on the island and sail off without him. Poor old Captain Flag.